For the first time, we present an approach for pose and shape reconstruction of two interacting hands that combines the following favorable properties. Our method runs in real time, uses a single consumer level depth sensor, handles inter and intra hand collisions, and automatically adjusts to the user's hand shape. We start with an input depth image that we feed to our correspondence regression network, CORN, to obtain per pixel predictions for hand segmentation and dense hand surface correspondences. Subsequently, we use these predictions in a generative pose and shape fitting framework. To this end, we minimize an energy function using an efficient Gauss-Newton solver that is implemented on a GPU. The final output of our system comprises both the hand pose and shape. Training our correspondence regression network requires dense pixel-wise annotations for depth images. Since these are infeasible to annotate on real data, we extend the live physical simulation system of Fershaw et al. To two hands. This gives us fully annotated data for two naturally and physically plausible interacting hands while avoiding interhand penetrations. To improve the generalization capabilities of our network, we add real data with automatically generated segmentation annotations to our training data. Here we show example frames from our dataset. As 3D hand representation, we make use of the recent parametric hand model for pose and shape, which was presented by Romero and colleagues. In addition, we extend the model by coupling it with soft 3D Gaussian collision proxies that enable a computationally efficient interpenetration avoidance. As input for the model fitting, we use the input depth image as well as the CORN predictions. Given the input point cloud with regress correspondences, we first find the best match for every model vertex. Then, we use this vertex to input mapping in the energy function eTotal. Our function includes point-to-point and point-to-plane fitting terms, regularizers for plausible pose and shape, as well as temporal smoothness and collision avoidance. In the following, we show the influence of different components on the overall performance. Not including the collision term in the optimization leads to physically implausible intersection artifacts, especially when the two hands are interacting closely. Removing either the shape or pose regularizer produces unnatural results, as shown here. Without real training data, the correspondence regressor produces significantly worse segmentation masks, as presented on the right, hence degrading the overall tracking performance. We compare to the commercial Leap Motion hand tracker. When two hands interact closely, their method often loses track of one hand completely. Additionally, their results are not robust under interhand occlusions. Our system struggles with very fast motion that leads to significant motion blur in the depth image, as shown here. Note how the tracking instantly recovers once the depth image quality improves again. In some cases, our temporal smoothness prior may cause a delay in the tracking. Since we use coarse collision proxies, small intersections, as in this example, may still happen. The CORN predictions are essential for our algorithm. Here, the index finger is erroneously predicted as middle finger, which degrades the final result. Here we show some live capture results of our method. Our approach is able to handle various complex two-hand interactions, including tight grasps and significant interhand occlusions. To demonstrate the automatic handshape personalization enabled by our approach, we reconstruct models for users with varying handshapes. Real-time hand tracking is a natural choice for interaction with virtual or augmented reality devices. Here, we present results from an example setup with an ecocentric shoulder-mounted depth camera. Thank you.